Once again, very good afternoon to all of you. Students, today we will start with lesson number 2, parallels and meridians. Dear students, first of all, let's discuss new terms. First is equator. Students, equator is the longest circle on the globe, which divides it into two equal parts. Let me show you on the screen. The longest circle on the globe, which divides it into two equal parts. Look at this diagram. This is equator in the middle of the globe, and it divides it into two equal parts. Next new term is parallels. Parallels are complete circles which are parallel to the equator and between the poles. Yes, dear students. Again, look at this diagram. Parallels are complete circles. These lines are the parallels. These are the complete circles which are parallel to the equator. These all lines are parallel to the equator. And between the poles, these are the poles. North pole, and at the bottom, there is South pole. And the next one is meridians. Meridians are the semicircles. Parallels are the complete circle, but meridians are the semicircles joining the North Pole and the South Pole. These are the meridians. Students, these are the meridians. Okay, these are the semicircles, means half circles, joining the North Pole and the South Pole. Next one is prime meridian. Again, look at the same diagram. This is the prime meridian. This is shown in red color. Prime meridian. The meridian passing through Greenwich. This meridian passing through Greenwich and marked as 0 degree. This is the prime meridian. Next is pole. Pole, the endpoints of Earth axis. I have shown you earlier also, these are the poles. Towards north, there is North Pole, and towards south, there is South Pole. And the last one, grid. Last new term is grid. The network of parallels and meridians on the globe or on the map. This look like a Look at this diagram. This look like net. Parallels. This is a network of parallels and meridians. Okay. This is a grid. Again, I am repeating the new terms. Equator. Vansham, what are you doing? Equator means the longest circle on the globe, which I have shown you in the diagram, which divides it into two equal parts. Then parallels, the complete circles. Parallels are the complete circles, which are parallel to the equator and between the poles. Which poles? North pole and the south pole. Third is meridians. These are the semicircles, means half circles, joining the north pole and the south pole. Prime meridian, that meridian passing through Greenwich and marked as 0° longitude. Then the poles, the end points of the earth axis. These are called poles. And the last one, grid. The network of parallels and meridians on the globe or on the map. I have shown you the grid also. Yes, look at the gear up exercise. Students, if A is 1, A means 1, B means 2, C means 3, A equal to 1, B second letter, it's equal to 2, C third letter, it is equal to 3, and so on. What does the code 7, 12, 15, 2, 5 stands for? The 7th letter is G, 12th is L, 15th is O, 2nd is B, and 5th is E. That means this stands for globe. Yes, dear students, let's start reading. We know that the shape of the earth, we know that the shape of the earth is like a bowl or a sphere. It is represented by a globe. What is the shape of the earth? All of you know that earth is spherical in shape. It is round in shape like a bowl, and it is represented by a globe. What is globe? It is a model of the earth. Various places have a definite location on the globe or on the map. Different places have definite location on the globe, like different continents, you can say different oceans, different countries. They have definite location on the map or on the globe. To locate or to mark a place in a city or in a country, we use its address. What do we need to locate or to mark a place in a city? We need an address. It includes the house number, the name of the street, road, and the city. All of you know that these things are included in the address. The house number, the name of street or road, and the name of city. Earlier means long, long ago, we did not have the address system for locating places. Long ago, there was no system of address. There were no colonies, no sectors, no house numbers were there. Globes or maps showed only the name of place. Now, we want a system to locate the places exactly on map or a globe. When there was no address system, then globes and maps showed only the names of that particular place. But now we want a system to mark the place exactly, or you can say accurately, on a map. A bowl or a sphere does not have a top or bottom or sides, which can possibly be used as a starting point. Yes, dear students, earth is like a bowl. Okay. There is no starting point of a spherical shape. No bottom, no top, no sides. The earth or a globe, Pankaj, be attentive in the class. Don't draw anything on the screen. The earth or a globe rotates around its axis. the earth rotates around the axis. Now, what is axis? Students, axis is an imaginary line about which a body rotates. Okay, for example, our earth rotates on its axis and it completes its rotation in 24 hours. Yes, axis is an imaginary line. This is axis. This is an imaginary line, not in real. The earth or a globe rotates around its axis and earth completes one rotation in 24 hours. The endpoints of the axis are fixed, which can be used as the starting point on the globe. These endpoints of axis, they are fixed and they are used as a starting point. Okay. We can call these two points as the North Pole and South Pole. These are the two points of axis, two end points of the axis, which are always fixed, which can be used as a starting point on the globe. And these two points are known as North Pole and South Pole. These two poles can help us to draw parallels and meridians. First of all, let's study about parallels. We can draw a circle on the globe in east-west direction and midway between the North Pole and South Pole. Students, again, listen very carefully. You can draw a circle. This is the circle that you can draw on the globe in east-west direction, from east, this is the west, this is the east direction, between and midway between the North Pole. Midway means in the middle of North Pole and South Pole. It is named as equator. I have explained you in new term also. This equator is between the North Pole and South Pole and it is marked as 0 degrees. And always keep in mind that this is the biggest circle that can be drawn on a globe. Equator is the biggest circle that can be drawn on a globe. The equator divides the globe into two equal parts. The part which is towards the north of the equator is called the northern hemisphere, and the part which is towards the south of the equator is called the southern hemisphere. Yes, dear students, this is the equator. This part which is in the towards the north, that is northern hemisphere, and the part towards the south is known as southern hemisphere. The part, yes, we can draw circles at equal distances parallel to the equator. These all parallels are at the equal distances from the equator. Okay. And the angular distance north or south of the equator is called latitude and is measured in degrees. These parallels are called the lines of latitudes. All these parallels, you can see the parallels, these lines. These parallels are called the lines of latitude. Okay. parallels are known as the lines of latitude. The parallels give us north-south direction. And the properties of parallels. The parallels are complete circles except the poles, which are points. These poles are only points. This north pole and south pole. These poles are only points. Otherwise, all the parallels are complete circles except these two, because they are only points, not circles. Next is, the parallels are drawn at equal distance from each other. The equator is the longest parallel and a great circle. And the last one, the length of other parallels decreases away from the equator towards the poles, and they are small circles. Again, look at this diagram. The length of other parallels. The length of the parallels. The length is decreases away from the equator in the northern sphere and in the southern hemisphere also. In both directions, the length of the parallels is decreasing, and they are the small circles. And equator is the largest circle. Now, the equator is marked as 0 degree latitude. The north pole is marked as 90 degree N. N means north. Students, I think you have drawn angle of 90 degree in mathematics also. 90 degree N. That is north pole at the 90 degree, south pole at the is marked as 90 degree S. S for south, N for north. Okay. If parallels are drawn at an interval of 1 degree, if we draw these parallels at the interval of 1 degree from north pole to south pole, then the total number of parallels are, including the equator, there will be 180 parallels. This is the diagram of parallels on the globe. If we draw these parallels at an interval of 1 degree from north to south pole, then the total number of parallels including the equator will be 181. That means the total number of parallels are 181. Due to the inclination of Earth axis, many parallels are important on the globe. Some of the parallels are very important on the globe. These are seven parallels are very important. Important parallels. This is the diagram of important parallels on the globe. First is 90 degree. The North Pole. Yes, dear students, sorry for disturbance. Yes, students, first is the North Pole, 90 degree at the top. Then Arctic Circle, that is 66 degree, 66 1 upon 2 degree N, or you can say 66.5 degree north. Third is the Tropic of Cancer. It is 23.5 degree north. Then the equator, 0 degree. Then the Antarctic Circle. Now towards the south, these are Antarctic Circle in the north, Arctic Circle, and in the south, Antarctic Circle, which is at 66.5 degrees south. Then Tropic of Capricorn, 23.5 degrees south. Then the South Pole, 90 degrees south. You have to learn these important parallels. And one more thing, you have to draw this diagram in your fair notebook. Important parallels on the globe. The heading is the important parallels on the globe. You have to draw this diagram in your notebook. Yes, dear students, now it's your turn. We will complete this chapter tomorrow. Students, we are going to unmute all of you. Excuse me, Akash sir. Excuse me, Akash sir.